The following program contains mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
I'm curious because you looked at this from a cultural, societal perspective. Dr. Armstrong, you're looking at it truly in terms of neurochemistry. From your angle, what are the best ways that we can protect kids from the addictive behaviors? Mm-hmm. If you know the smartphone's potentially addictive, how do we protect kids?
I think just first putting limitations on the phone, how much time they can use the phone, perhaps half of that, 2 to 3 hours a day. So putting absolute limits on it. Also, there's a blue light in these screens that stimulates our brain and can interfere with melatonin and interfere with your sleep cycle. And we all know what lack of sleep does to the brain. So it's recommended not to have a smartphone or screen time 2 hours before going to bed. I think it's also smart to put phone-free zones in your life. One of the things that they've noticed with young kids is that their attention span is only 5 minutes, when studies show that they now start wanting to get other sort of interactions. So phone-free zones would be family time, dinner time, maybe study time. Take the phone away so you don't have a constant, continuous bombardment Yep. of stimulation. So I think you can set parameters, which definitely involves the parent in setting those parameters for kids. The teenage brain is being rewired for adulthood. It's extremely plastic. New pathways are being laid down. And if you're just stimulating the brain in one manner with all of these lights and so forth, you're only going to develop those pathways. And the brain is very efficient. Not only will you just develop those pathways, but the brain will prune and not develop other pathways. So it's also taking away from that well-rounded education that where you need social interaction, you need academic interaction, you need physical interaction, you need all sorts of different interactions for the brain to fully develop all of its pathways.
So with
makes
us,
so much sense.
So with us, when we're kids, there was no smartphones, so I had to get excited about running down to the creek and throwing pebbles, and that was right. my reward. But why do that if I've got my reward right here in my smartphone?
That's right.
Unless you limit that smartphone. So you hear this now.
Yeah. Things were so different then. You know, we would pick up the phone when it rang in the kitchen, and it was connected to the wall. So mom and dad and everybody else were there, and then you'd find out who it is. Now, when your phone rings, you can either hit accept or decline and act like that person just doesn't even exist. Right? Because you know who it is, and kids are developing this idea that sort of the world revolves around them. They're the center of their universe. I have options and drop-down menus for everything in my life, and I should have a drop-down menu for my dinner tonight too, right, Mom? Like, I don't like chicken. What do I, right? I mean, this is sort of, and we wonder why our kids are, they seem so entitled, nothing's ever good enough for them, they want what they want it instantly, and we have to say that, well, you know, part of this is not their fault. Part of them, they're being developed and cultured to sort of think this way because most of their digital world has conditioned them like that. That's not an excuse to be disrespectful or dishonoring to their parents, but it is understandable because that's what their world is developing into.
I would encourage people at home, both parents, because watch your own behavior, but talk with your kids, because if social media, cell phones have taken over all of your lives, you all need to get in a room and have a conversation the old-fashioned way, because awareness is the only way we're going to be able to prevent kids from becoming truly addicted.
For example, too, if you're a social media freak yourself, as a parent, you're just setting an example. Your kids are more likely to follow in your footsteps.
That's right. And I think my biggest takeaway after making this documentary is to realize that it's no mistake that kids need parents. You know, kids think that they're their own authority now, that they're connected to the internet, and that data is all they need. But you know what? Parents have something called wisdom. That's what our kids need, much more than information. They need wisdom.
From you,
like, Dad, what do I do? I have two choices that seem legitimate, and you say, but son, this is the wise choice, this is the foolish choice, and that comes from your character. That's why kids need parents more than just a smartphone.
I'm excited for your documentary. It's called Connect. You can go to our website, thedoctorstv.com, to find out more about Kirk's documentary. Everyone in the audience is going to be going home with a copy of it, so enjoy. Dr. Armstrong, thank you so much. Kirk, keep up the great work.